coming to you from the Lake Placid Olympic Jumping Complex, the venue of the 1932 and 1980 Olympic Games, and totally refurbed and modernized only last year. A great shot from the top of the hill gives you a really good idea of how, well, terrifying it would be for us mere mortals, but it's undaunting for the athletes that are preparing to launch themselves off those ramps. Conditions looking pretty good. It's been another sunny day, although the clouds have come in a bit since sunset, and that may stop the temperature plunging a little bit. -3, it was a lot colder last night. But most importantly, it's a calm night with little breeze at the moment. And that is the technicalities of the hill and what faces the athletes. 90-meter hill, so athletes get 60 points for jumping to the K point. As we watch the four jumpers just testing the landing area. Now, for every meter over or behind that K point, that 90 meter point, an athlete gains or loses 2 points. This is how they go. We've got 11 women representing four countries, and you've got to fancy Japan's chances for medals tonight. Some would say it's just a case of how many medals for Japan. So hopefully we're going to get lots of action for those who have come to the jumping complex to enjoy the action. First up is Machiko Kubota of Japan, 19 years old, from Waseda University, a student of sports science. Her coach with the flag, giving her an idea of the breeze, and you can see how little breeze there was, so I don't think we're going to have any delay to this particular jump. And our first competitor in the women's normal hill individual is away. Nice style, nice launch from Kubota. Not far off the 90 meter mark. 88.5 for Michiko Kubota of Japan. So added to 88.5, we've got 108.1 for Kubota. So second to go is Miki Ikeda. She managed 75 meters in the training jump earlier this afternoon. 19 years old, also goes to Waseda University. She's off. Shorter jump than her compatriot, Kubota. 71 meters, so she'll be disappointed by that. Nice control, though. That is one of the features that the judges are looking for. They don't like too much movement of the body whilst they fly through the air. So a total for her of 69.3. The oldest of the four Japanese athletes, Fushigeta. Clean landing, the telemark style. That's what they're looking for. They're looking for her style through the air, her body position through the air, but also the landing is very important for the judges. 67 meters only. It's over to 19-year-old Mizuki Sato. So part of getting distance is getting height off the end of the ramp.
young woman is attending Yihan University.
That was 70 meters distance, so better than Shigeta, total of 67.3. Okay, our first contestant now from America, Anna Ziegman from North Hennepin Community College. Just waiting for her coach to give her the go-ahead. Well, 56.5 the distance, so what a short distance, the least distance travelled of any of the five competitors so far. Remember, the points from the first round get added to the second round points to decide who is the winner. Poland's Anna Twardosz doesn't need anywhere near that sort of time. She launches off the end of the slope, and that is a good jump. Almost made it to the K point, and a good landing as well. And you see how explosive that squat was as she stood up and went through the air. And that distance, 85.5 for the pole. Up next, Kazakhstan's Veronika Shishkina, athlete in this from Tajikistan. And it's a good jump, but lacking in distance. Lacking in distance, she shakes her head.
Yeah, it's 75.
She's been given 74 meters. So 76.1 points altogether, and that puts her into third place. This is Kara Larson of the United States, 22 years old. And American fans will recognize the name. She's the sister of two times US ski jumping Olympian Casey Larson. Larson is going. Good launch off the pad. Probably a little bit short. A good landing, arms outstretched as they should be. That's what the judges are looking for. Distance of 78.5. Let's see what the points are. So 85.6, and that puts her into third place. Kinga Rajda of Poland. Twice Polish national champion, member of their national senior team. Hugely experienced, high hopes are resting on her for a medal in this competition. Nice launch off the slope and a good length as well. Good telemark landing. Now, what do the judges make of that? Her distance was 86.5, so just a little short of the K point. Oh, that right ski going a little bit wide. But her points, 102.5, put her into second place. Up next, Paulina Cizla, one of two Polish athletes yet to go. She's happy with it. And she got 80.5, so that is a huge improvement on her training jump. Keeping the hands out to the sides, vitally important. If you start waving your hands around, apart from being marked down on points, you also start breaking, and that slows you down. 95.5 points for Paulina, and that puts her into fourth place overall. The last athlete to go is Nicole Konderla of Poland. Represents Katowice Sports Club. They'll be cheering the 21-year-old on as she launches herself off the slope. Looking good, and a really good long jump as well. Nice style, nice landing, and great distance. 90.5, the furthest jumped yet. And surely that's good enough to put her top. A few 17.5s and 17s from the judges, and total points of 117.2, and that does put her top and gives her a 9-point advantage going into the second round. Those are the standings then, confirmation of the points and the positions, with Konderla of Poland in first, Kubota or in second, so those were the last and the first jumpers of that round. Then we've got Poland in third and fourth and fifth. Kara Larson of the USA, best placed American, in sixth. And then we've got two more Japanese athletes and Anna Siegman in 11th. She will go first in the final round. So the final round of the women's normal hill individual about to get underway, with 18-year-old Anna Siegman going first. The woman from Minneapolis trying to beat her first round distance. And a little bit short, 60.5. So that is, I think, actually better than she did in the first jump. 60.5, yeah, so she's 4 meters further than her first jump. Total of 40.7 points. Next up is Japan's Fu Shigeta, and looking to improve on her distance of 67 meters. She's currently sitting on 64.8 total points so far. You see them practicing that in the car park with their coaches, just leaping up. And the leap off the bottom of the hill is absolutely crucial in getting flight and distance. And the top athletes can actually jump from a standing position and jump their own height. Well, she managed 72.5, so not a bad jump. 69.7 points in total. Coming up next is our third jumper, Mizuki Sato, 19 years old from Japan. Real strength and depth in the Japanese squad. It's short, a tentative landing. She's smiling, but you got the impression by the slap of her arms that she felt she could have done better. She managed 71 meters. Pretty average scores, though, from the judges, giving her a total of 64.2, a total of 131.5. That puts her into second place. This is Miki Ikeda from Waseda University. She's got her sights on the 2026 Olympics in Milan. This is all part of the learning and the experience that you've got to gain before you can get to that top level. 72.5 is her distance. You know, traveling to these events is also about the experience of travel. It's her first time abroad, her first time competing outside Japan. So she will go away, as you can see, with a big smile on her face. No medals this time, but keep an eye on the name, Shishkina of Kazakhstan. mental strength is a huge factor in ski jumping, as you can imagine. Launching yourself from that position down a hill like that takes a huge amount of courage. Veronika Shishkina is away. Held her skis well. The distance. So up there with some of the current leaders. Mostly 16s from the judges. 78.4, so she now has 154.5, and that's good enough to put her top of the standings. So big smile from her. Big cheer from the crowd at the bottom of the hill. USA's Kara Larsen, 22 years old. Put in a really big jump to move up the leaderboard. And it was pretty good. 81.5 meters for her. And that's, yeah, that is longer than her first jump, so she's improved. And that is enough to put her top of the standings overall, and that will really please the crowd that have come out to support her. But now we're getting to the busy end of the standings. Paulina Schiesler of Poland, one of the first of four Polish athletes yet to go. Currently sitting fifth overall. Good jump, short of the K line, but K point, I should say, but really good jump. 85 meters. So she's managed to add 5 meters onto her first round jump. And the judges like the style as well. And I think that's going to be enough to put her top of the standings. Yes, it is, 195.5. So by some distance, Larsen in second is 178.2. So Paulina Schiesler of Poland doing really well on that final jump. Right, we're into the top four from the first round. This is where we expect the medals to be decided. First to go, Anna Twardosz. She jumped 85.5 in the first round. Oh, that's a big one. Lands on that red line. Now, the all-important judges' points are going to matter. She held it together well, didn't she? Good position. Always in control. 90. She was given 90 meters. Landed exactly on that red line.
That was a 90-meter jump, so an excellent job for
206.9. She goes top of the leaderboard. Kinga Rajda of Poland to go next. Now she managed 86.5 meters. She's got 102.5 points. She's going to need to get more than that to match Twardosz now. Oh, and another good jump from the Polish athlete, Kinga Rajda. I think that was beyond the K point. Oh no, it's been given just under 89.5 meters. The judges looking at that style, they want to see the legs absolutely straight, the toes bent upwards at the ankles. at the landing. It's got to be a telemark landing. It wasn't quite. One foot should be further ahead than the other. But Kinga Rajda has got enough points to put her top of the standings. Kinga Rajda, the woman to beat right now. Only two more to go. Machiko Kubota, sitting on 108.1. She needs at least 101 points, 102 points to move into the lead. Years old, one of two athletes here representing Waseda University. Can she get the distance? I think she has. But what about the style points now? 89 meters. So that is further than she managed in the first round. She's just getting better and better. What about the landing style though? The judge is giving us some good points. I'm seeing 17s and 17 and a halves coming through. So a total of 224.8, and that puts her in the gold medal position. So with just one more jumper to go, Machiko Kubota holds the gold medal position. Kinga Rajda of Poland is silver, and Anna Szwardos is third, the other pole. So can Nicole Kundela hold her nerve and repeat the terrific jump she did in the first round? The pressure is immense. Nicole Kundela jumps for the gold medal. Just behind that 90 meter line. Will it be long enough? It was dead on 90 meters. That's the official distance. Let's just have a look at that style. It's looking good. The judges, I think, will like that. But will it be enough points to put her top? She's waiting for the scores to come up as we are. 231.6. Nicole Kundela of Poland wins the gold medal. What a terrific performance. Two jumps of 90 meters, one in fact 90.5. And the judges liked her style. Nicole Kundela of Poland, gold medal for her. Japan take the silver through Machiko Kubota. And then another Polish medal, the bronze for Kinga Rajda in third. Nicole Kundela of Poland wins the competition, takes that gold medal, and they'll be celebrating at the Katowice Sports Club that she represents. So, a thrilling competition in the women's normal hill individual.